What's up guys, Emmanuel here. Today I'm going to show you how to install and use my new plugin, the Mesh Import for Substance Designer. To install it, all you need to do is copy the folder called show-less-the-mesh to the Substance Designer Python plugins folder. Usually located at Documents, Algorithmic, Substance Designer, Python, SD User Plugins. Once copied, open the folder and open the license.lig file. This is basically a text file, so you can use Notepad. Replace the Your License Here text with the license you got from Gumroad. Save and close it. Finally, we need to connect a renderer for the mesh. I wanted this plugin to be fully standalone, so I created both a ray trace and a real-time renderer from scratch. Also build them in Python and C++ to improve the performance. Sadly, the results are a lot slower to almost all the commercial renderers you can find, so I decided the standalone wasn't the best path for the end user. And of all the other options I found, the best balance between accessibility and speed was Blender, since you know anyone can get it for free, and for what we need is pretty fast. If you guys are interested, let me know and I'll add other renderers like maybe Octane Standalone or another GPU-based renderer. Didn't use them as my first option because not everyone can access Octane or Redshift, but everyone can easily grab Blender from their website. Back to the installation. To connect Blender, first you need to install Blender 2.79b. I know Blender 2.8 is out, but for what we need, there is no real benefit of using it, and it's still beta. Once installed, open the path.json file in the plugins folder and set the path to the Blender exe. Usually located at Program Files, Blender Foundation, Blender. Be sure to replace all the backslashes to forward slashes and to include the Blender exe in the path. Now the plugin should be ready to be used. So we open Substance Designer and create a new graph. If everything was installed correctly, you'll find two new buttons, one that is a cube and another one that is a cube with a yellow arrow. To keep the plugin flexible, I added two scenarios, the performance efficient one in which you only need a specific height map of the mesh with a defined rotation, and the flexible one in which you can benefit of being able to rotate the mesh inside Substance Designer, like when you want to scatter the mesh around. The button with a cube is the performance efficient one, and the cube with the yellow arrow is the flexible one. So let's learn how to use them. First, we'll see how to use the performance focused option. Click the button with a cube and a new window will appear. Here, we need to select the mesh, set the resolution of the image, set the name of the resource, and define a rotation. Now we click Load Mesh, and a couple of things will happen. If you see the package, a new resource folder called Meshes will be added, and inside of it, a subfolder with the same name you defined for the mesh in the plugin. Inside the subfolder, you'll find all the maps. The maps will be created in the same place in which your original mesh was located in your file system. Also, two bitmaps will be added to your graph, and a node called UVMapper will be connected to the UVs. This node will help to set any texture to the mesh you added, as you can see here. If your mesh doesn't have UVs, the map will be black, so you can easily remove it and only use the height map that was created. Also, if you want to update the bitmaps, just make sure you are using the same name for the mesh and click Load again. Be careful, because if you use the same name, it will update the resource and as a consequence all the instances of the bitmap in your graph, as you can see here. Now, let's see how to use a flexible option. Click the button with a cube and a yellow arrow, and a new window will appear. Select the mesh file. Set the name, the resolution, and click Load Mesh. The plugin will begin creating all the required maps and the node. Performance-wise, I was able to get all the 40 maps of the mesh with 1 million faces and a resolution of 1K in 7 minutes. I was using a Ryzen 1800 first generation with no overclocking. Once the process is finished, you'll see again that the maps are added as a resource in the subfolder. And in this case, a new node is created. The name will be the one you gave plus the node suffix. The same as with the other options, the node will be added to the graph alongside the UV mapper. Sadly, at the moment there is a limitation in the Python API for Substance Designer, so you need to do a manual step to make everything work. Once it is fixed in the next release, I'll automate it. So first of all, close the mesh import window, otherwise Substance Designer will crash. Now open the node that was created. Go to the node properties by double clicking in the grid, and you'll see an input parameter called position. Change the editor from slider to position, and add the label position. That's all. Now, if we go back to our graph, double click the node, and you'll be able to rotate it. And there you go, you have your mesh inside Substance Designer. Well, that's all for now, so don't forget to tag me in all the cool substances you create with this. And if you have any suggestions or feedback, join the Discord server and let me know.
Good luck!